variety of blocks available in LandFX that provide time-saving functionality. Dim scale blocks allow the block to remain the same size regardless of the scale. This is particularly useful for things that can get lost in large-scale plans. For example, in this paper space layout, there are multiple viewports, each with a different scale. If we look at this transformer symbol, we can see that because it is not a dim scale block, it becomes more difficult to interpret the larger the scale. Let's make a custom lighting transformer dim scale block. This will allow us to use it at any scale and it will remain legible. To begin, let's move this symbol off into model space. This will not only make it easier to work with, but it will also give us a cleaner looking preview slide when we save it. Next, we need to check our units and scale. We can type units and hit enter to open the units dialog box. We are in architectural inches. Next, let's check our scale by selecting the scale tool from the FX site ribbon. We can see that our scale is set to 1:1. With this in mind, let's see how big our transformer symbol currently is. Using the dimension command, we can see that the circle is 2 feet across. If we make our dim scale block how it is currently drawn, it'll be much too large.
We want the block to be drawn in the exact dimensions that we want it to display in paper space.
Let's go ahead and scale this down to a more reasonable size. Typing SC in the command line will activate the scale tool. In this case, we will scale it down to 0.035 of its current size. Now, we can see that the symbol is a little less than an inch across. This should be about right. With a symbol at a more appropriate size, we can select all of the line work, type Save Block in the command line, and press Enter. Next, we will specify the insertion point. In this case, we can use the center, and then specify where we want to save the block. For this example, we will choose to save it under Discipline Graphics, User Defined. We will give the block a name and click Save. Now, we want to give the block a description. Make sure to choose Dim Scale for the Scale option, select our appropriate units, and set the rotation to manual. Now we are ready to test our new dim scale block. We can head on over to the paper space layout. Navigate to our User Defined Blocks folder using the tool from the FX site ribbon, and select our new block. As we place it, we can see that it retains its scale regardless of which viewport we place it in. And there you have it. Creating dim scale blocks with LandFX is a breeze. For more power tips like the one you just watched, head on over to landfx.com/powertips.